welcome to my channel. So today, after a few weeks of break from riding this bike, the Derwent Pioneer, I'm going to take it for a ride off-road to see how it handles the hills. So I'll do like some hills test and to see how comfortable to ride this bike off-road, because it's 4-inch tires, so very thick. It should be good to ride on the snow or sand, off-road, basically all terrain. Currently I have about 95% battery, and I rode already almost 7 miles, and I charged the battery about a little bit over 2 weeks ago. So I'm gonna ride the bike straight to the mountains. I'll not drive the car, so it would be more fun. And as you can see, the handlebar is super wide, like 28 inches are good. And you can feel a lot of torque, but at the same time, this bicycle have a smooth transition, so it's not give you like really crazy kick. It's a very nice settings they have. So basically some pedal assist will kind of kick in so strong that you can fall from the bicycle. With this one, it feels power, but it's more smoother. And riding this bike like on the walking path, it's a little bit of course narrow, so it's because of wide handlebars. So yes, I don't recommend to ride like I do. It's better to ride on the street, but we have so much cars over here, they are crazy going fast. And it's only 3 miles ride over here up to the mountains. So I decide just to be safer and not to ride too quick on the road, because if there is some people walking right now, the weather is beautiful. I don't know, like few days ago we have like rain, huge storm. And yesterday, 2 days ago, we went for the snow in the mountains, so we have some sliding. And today in LA, the temperature was like between 37 Fahrenheit, and now it's about probably 50 or 55, but it feels much warmer on the sun. I'm riding on the speed number 3 on Shimano, and then pass 2, so it's pedal assist level 2, only like 12 miles an hour, 30 miles an hour. This way will not take much battery, and I have 85% still, and already 9 miles, so it's only 15% and 9 miles. Hopefully this display show me accurate information, because I know that some companies, they show full battery and then with the next few miles your battery suddenly dead. But we'll see. This I like the way it's percentage over here, because some company like have a display with just a bar, and those bars jump up and down sometimes, or just completely dead. I have like another bike I rode, it was 4 bars and 3 bars, and I rode like, I said I can ride another 10 miles, and with the next mile it was dead. So not as good for preparation. If you going somewhere fine, you think you have juice in your battery, but then it's dead. So we'll see how the battery will act. Hopefully I don't have to pedal much back, so the battery will be still good. And I'm almost there now. So I'm going all the way, not this mountain, but through the canyon, and go probably to some new route to check it out. All right, so I'm at the entrance now to the canyon for this ride, and as you can see, I removed few layers because it's getting hot. The sun is actually burning, feels like 85 degrees under the sun, so getting very hot. So I just wear a t-shirt. Wow. But the air, I can feel it's a bit colder, but still I just to more comfortable like this, back to the summer. And so far my experience is great. I think it's one of the best bike as comfort level Of course, well, I have another one which also about the same, but that's one 20 inch, but this one 26, it should be much more comfortable to ride off-road because the bigger wheels, and as you can see, we have so many rains, so it might be a little bit muddy, and I think it will be muddy around, so hopefully we will not get that dirty. Only I will need to be careful not to slide. Wow, that's actually really muddy, but it's good experience. And my first time riding in the mud and also on this bike. This bike have only like front suspension, very soft. I'm not sure if I will make it to these mountains, let's see. Because some bikes are not as stable and I was afraid to slide. So let's see if I can make it on this bike now. Should be, because should be a lot of torque in this bike. Yeah, actually, wow, it made it very good, and also feels really comfortable, like, and secure that it will not slide, because the other bike I tried, I was afraid to slide, it didn't feel very comfortable on that bike. And it's a different condition right now, as you can probably see. It's a little bit muddy, so slippery. Wow, it's still wet and muddy. That's why I didn't go bike early. I was waiting until it dry up a little bit, but it's still a little bit muddy, and I'll see how good the mud guards are. So I'm going a little bit uphill over here. Some bikes will handle it very well, some are not. So we'll see how it's go. Pass one, I'll go to PS two now. Yes, I can go much faster here since there's not many people now. Probably go on PS three. It's a lot of gravel and actually some mud, as you can see. Wow. But so far so good. Oh, there's more mud up front. So we do have a lot of mud because it's nice. So far the guards helps to get not that much dirt on me. So far clean. I'll show you at the end of the video if the mud guards works and how much they work, because it's very important too sometimes for some people. So far I have 74% battery because now I'm getting more torque out of this bike. I'm going about 14 and half, 15 miles an hour uphill on level 3. I'm not trying to go very fast, but it's been very easy so far. It gave me a lot of kicks. 750 watt motor really helps a lot. Now it's gonna be more uphills and more muddy. So we are getting, actually today it's one of the toughest ride gonna be for this bike, because usually I go when it's warm, no mud, dry weather, but it's been raining for a week. And let's see if I can go uphill. And this bike is like 75 pounds. Wow, I think last time I've been here, there was nothing on this road, it was all good. As you can see, the water did a lot of corrosion to this area. And with this bike, you just jump over it, it's nothing. Wow. It's good that I took this bike today, because I wanted to take a 20-inch Nesta, and probably not today, for sure. Tomorrow it's gonna be, yeah, it's actually, if you check some videos at the end, I'll post at the end of this video, to travel to the same road, so you can compare and see how much difference the road conditions now. So many corrosions, actually a lot of rain, a lot of water. Wow, should be very beautiful in a few weeks. Everything's going to be green. As you can see now, it's grass already start to come out. And actually, just past one of the hills, it's a bike. Went uphill, very simple. No really pedaling a lot, but I try to get workout. That's why I'm going second speed, PS2. And I'm a little bit surprised. I have not adjusted the derailleurs on this bicycle, only the brakes a little bit, and the way it's positioned on the handlebar. And as you can hear, most likely I have no problems to switching the speed. The derailleurs already was adjusted, or is it just better quality? So out of the box, you can ride this bicycle without even turning on, like without adjusting the derailleurs in my case. Not sure how every single bicycle will be, but so far I think it's just high quality Shimano part. So yeah, it already works just great. Wow, it's really bumpy here, but yeah, I wish it has an extra rear suspension if you're riding a lot of bumps area, but the front suspension works really good. It's very soft and responsive. So actually it's even better than one I have on the G-Force, I think, the one I put the air fork. So this one is a really nice fork, aluminum as well. And it does take a lot of absorption from this corrosions and all. And because this bike have very wide and comfortable handlebar and hold, like it's pretty comfortable to hold it, so your hands will not get tired, fatigue much. So I think I will get some workout today, but every time when I ride the bicycle in the mountains, electric bicycle, I don't feel much workout, but when I come home next day, my feet hurts, muscle hurts. Hi. So going uphill really nicely, 750 watt motor works really nice over here. I think there's way to see how much torque, I believe. Let's see if I can switch to see it. Oh yes, you can see how much torque it takes. Yo. Let's see if I can go up. Yeah, it's actually very easy. Wow. Oh yeah, it's a, give me good pedal assist. Thank you. Okay, I'll go to pedal assist level 1 because you don't go uphill more than 10 miles. And the hills pretty steep up here. And let's see it going. But now it's about 850 watt. The water, the motor peak. So it's not the top. So it's actually good. Because I think when I rode Nesta, I was getting up to 950, I think, sometimes. So I'm on top of the valley. I think it's San Fernando Valley, and this area most likely like Calabasas area. And it's very beautiful. You can see some snow uphill. It's like Big Bear, that area. And you cannot see downtown, but that one is Woodland Hills downtown, I guess. And it's all beautiful and a lot of mud, but we're on big bike today, so it's mud is not big deal. Actually, it's handled very well off-road as this all-terrain bike. Right now it's gonna be one of the toughest hill, and let's see if it will go up, and then after that it will be just nice ride, maybe with some mud. And I have battery already 54%, 13 miles on it. So hopefully I'll get 20 miles, because I charged like over two and a half weeks ago. I charged the bike most likely. Okay, so this is a hill. And never pull your handlebar on you, because you can do wheelie on these powerful bikes. So it made it real nice, up to 880 watt peak, and looks good over here. It's all the way on top of this desert, I guess, mountains. Okay, so now I'm gonna go try to go uphill over here. As you can see, it's a very steep hill, off-road completely, like somewhere, and I want to take some pictures uphill. But wow, it's going just as easy. It's just probably much easier than walking. Wow, the motor is powerful, and the peak right now, let's see how fast, up to 900 peak, and it's beautiful. Wow, such a view. Look on this view, it's just beautiful. To be able to get here without even walking, and the bike is so strong and so soft. And this is not a review yet. I have to give more tests to this bike. So far, 10 out of 10 by all means. Soft ride, suspension, very good working, brakes superior. No noise, the shifting, it's so smooth, no problem at all. As previous bike, you need to adjusted with this bike. I don't have to adjust anything so far, only the brakes adjusted a little bit, that's it. So it's all the way on the top of the mountains in this area, so very nice ride today, beautiful weather. The only thing is I'm running out of time because I need to pick up my kids today from school. And as you can see, it can go not only uphills and downhills, the brakes are perfect. The traction of this bike is amazing actually. It's a little bit muddy over here, but I feel very comfortable riding this bicycle here, even in muddy area. And I will ride for another probably few minutes up this way. As you can see, it's more greenish now, so probably in a week I should come back. It will be very beautiful over here. Wow, it's all greenish now, so yeah, for another week it will be nice. And I'll try to go off-road. It's always nice to go through the small trail like this. Never been in this trail actually. And I didn't put any slime yet in this tire, so I need to put the slime just in case. So I'm gonna do probably just ride a little bit off-road right here and go back. I have about 4 miles or 6 miles to go back, and I have 57% battery now since I took some break to take some pictures. I'll post a lot of pictures at the end of this video, so don't forget hit subscribe and like, and wait until, or scroll down to the end of the video if you want to see some beautiful pictures. And it's amazing ride today. I'm glad that I were able to go today because we have bad weather for almost few weeks. Not bad, but rainy, so I couldn't ride the bicycle. I didn't want to ride in rain unless I have to somewhere. But it's very beautiful for the video today. Wow, never been in this area actually that far. And it's like riding on regular road. It does not really feel like you're riding off-road because of this fat tires and big bike, huge like motorcycle handlebar and tires. And I think I am in Hidden Hills or somewhere like Kardashians live and all the celebrities. And let's see if I will go down. I will probably not go down there. Looks like it's cemetery there or something. Never been there before. People have horses over here, ranches, very beautiful. But I may go later when I have more time. I still have like 54% battery left, and I'm just gonna go all the way around. Right now I'm gonna make a turn and ride back, and I'll show you. Okay, so now I'm completely off-road. Hopefully I will not get function, because I need to ride another 4 or 5 miles back home. Oh, nice. So it should be fun to ride back now, so you will be able to see how steep the hills when you're going downhill. I'll show you as well. And this video might be too long, and if you think it's too long, please comment below. Should I just cut in the future to make, what do you think guys? How long should the video be? 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour? Because it's not a regular like a review video, this is just my experience video how to ride off-road. But again, I wish to ride in the snow this bike to see how it will handle the snow. I'm pretty sure it will handle the snow very well as well. As you can see, I came from the right, from this side, so go back. And it's very easy to get lost in these mountains. And I didn't go to top speed today, surprisingly. I'm not sure why. Usually I go very fast, but with this bike, it's so comfortable, like Cadillac. You just don't want to go fast. You just want to enjoy the ride. And I'm going one PSI, so PS. So pedals is level 1. If I go level 3, wow, it will be much faster, of course. Ooh. 50 miles, but over here I don't want to go that fast, and you'll see why. Over here it's a steep hill, and actually, wow, it's handling the brakes are really good, one of the best I had. I know there might be some better for more expensive, I'm not sure, but so far it's stopped and controlled as much as I want to, because it's very important not to have the brakes which will just lock you in. It's just to feel the comfort as much so you will not slip or slide, so it's good. The brakes work just great. I wish I find some negative about this bike so I can give you some cons on this, and the only negative, but it's normal, I guess. I can see it's just a weight of this bike, 75 pounds, not for everyone who needs to carry to the second floor, but you will not be able to find any bike lighter than this in this type of category, so it's just normal. It's not really, I cannot say it's bad. I mean, it's not something abnormal with the bike, it's just normal weight for this type of bike. Actually it's really good weight, because some bikes are more heavy than this one. It's a huge bike, like motorcycle mostly. Okay, so now I have 50% battery left, and hopefully it will be accurate, so by the time I came home it will be about maybe 40. So now I rode almost 50 miles on this bicycle today. Today I rode about, not that much actually. I try not to ride a lot because I want to get some pictures, just enjoy. And I didn't have much time. So downhill is going really nice. And you probably can hear the brake. Since it's hydraulic, it makes some noise. All of the hydraulics brake, you can hear the front one. I'm not sure why. Only the front one making this noise, but all of them. My other bike with hydraulic brakes, they do the same thing. So it's normal. And as you can see, the road has got crazy bad here. It's not, I'm not sure. Last time it was much better road, like maybe a month ago I've been here riding a mountain bike. But I can tell you that I enjoy this bicycle more than any other bicycle road in these mountains. I do like Aspen, Nesta, but I think it would be kind of harder to go through all these corrosions on the road in mud, I'm not sure. Never rode that one in mud yet. But I might take it next time. It's really like motorcycle because the tire is so big. It jump over the small hill so easy. So going down hills 50 miles, it's not fast, I know, but I don't want to go very fast on this bike. It's my first time actually going to the mountains on this bike, but I know it can handle it much faster speed easier because the tire is fat and good tractions. But hey, I'm not in a rush. Actually very easy to switch. And it's a little bit muddy over here. Not good. I'll show you at the end of the video if I got any more mud on myself. It's muddy over here as well. Nice. Looks like it's good. Yeah, I know that some bikes have the guards, but it's like a piece of garbage. And this one, it works really good. That's why some bicycle, I don't even put the guard, mud guard on it, because it's useless. Sometimes just extra weight. But I'm happy that I have on this bike, because it does work very well. Because it's wide enough. It's a little bit muddy over here as well. It's a lot of mud over here because the water probably coming from the mountains. Yeah, it's muddy, but I'm really happy that I took this bike up to the hills today, because many other bike would probably fall if I took the other bike in the mud. The traction would not be as this, most likely. Jump. Actually, I jump over easy. With most bikes I stop usually. Hello. And over here, it's a little bit at the middle and muddy. But all good, so far all good. I'm almost out. So I'm going 22 miles, 23 and a half. I'm gonna stop over here just for a second to show you if I get any mud on myself. So let me show you close up. So all the mud, it's a little bit over here, just a little bit. Everything looks clean. Just a little bit over here, but almost nothing. A little bit mud over here. And that's it, this side is clean. My pants are clean, completely, 100% clean. Not a single dot. And I cannot see my back, but amazing, actually. Actually, I'm impressed how good the mud guard, and you can see the tires are dirty. And there's some mud over here, but that's not bad. It didn't get on me, I guess. Just need to wash the bike. I guess that's all. Thank you guys for watching. I really appreciate your time and support. Please hit subscribe if you're not subscribed yet to my channel. I'll make more videos about this bicycle, so you can consider if you like it or not. This is not the cheapest, but I think it's worth the money. Every penny you pay for more expensive bike, you get exactly what you're paying. Better quality, better support, better parts in it, and you'll enjoy much more. All right, so I'm at home. Bike looks good. So I rode total on this bicycle 18.8 miles. The battery is still 45%. Looks like it's most accurate because it just drops a little by a little. So we'll see how much miles I can suck out of this battery. But so far so good. 18 miles. When I left home it was like 7, I believe. So it's about 11 miles I put on this bike today. But it was mostly mountains. Looks good. And mods. And as you can see, the bike didn't get as dirty. Again, thank you guys for watching. I enjoy the ride. I hope you enjoy the video. And I'll see you in the next video. See you later.